I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. I communicate now. Question 83.1. Questioner, could you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. It is as previously stated. Question 83.2. Questioner, could you please tell me why the instrument now gains weight after ascension instead of losing it? Answer, I am Ra. To assume that the instrument is gaining the weight of the physical bodily complex due to ascension or working with Ra is erroneous. The instrument has no longer any physical material which, to any observable extent, must be used in order for this contact to occur. This is due to the determination of the group that the instrument shall not use the vital energy which would be necessary since the physical energy complex level is in deficit. Since the energy, therefore, for these contacts is a product of energy transfer, the instrument must no longer pay this physical price. Therefore, the instrument is not losing the weight. However, the weight gain, as it occurs, is the product of two factors. One is the increasing sensitivity of this physical vehicle to all that is placed before it, including that towards which it is distorted in ways you would call allergic. The second factor is the energizing of these difficulties. It is fortunate for the outlook of this contact and the incarnation of this entity that it is not distorted towards the overeating, as the overloading of this much distorted physical complex would override even the most fervent affirmation of health illness and turn the instrument towards the distortions of illness health or, in the extreme case, the physical death. Question 83.3. Questioner, thank you. I'm going to ask a rather long, complex question, and I would request that the answer to each portion of this question be given if there was a significant difference prior to the veil than following the veil, so that I can get an idea of how what we experience now is used for better polarization. What was the difference before the veil in the following while incarnate in third density: sleep, dreams, physical pain, mental pain, sex, disease, catalyst programming, random catalyst relationships, and communication with the higher self or with the mind, body, spirit totality or any other mind, body, or spirit functions before the veil that would be significant with respect to their difference after the veil? Answer, I am Ra. Firstly, let us establish that both before and after the veil the same conditions existed in time-space, that is, the veiling process is a space-time phenomenon. Secondly, the character of experience was altered drastically by the veiling process. In some cases, such as the dreaming and the contact with the higher self, the experience was quantitatively different due to the fact that the veiling is a primary cause of the value of dreams and is also the single door against which the higher self must stand awaiting entry. Before veiling, dreams were not for the purpose of using the so-called unconscious to further utilize catalyst, but were used to learn, teach from, teach learners within the inner planes as well as those of outer origins of higher density. As you deal with each subject of which you spoke, you may observe, during the veiling process, not a quantitative change in the experience but a qualitative one. Let us, as an example, choose your sexual activities of energy transfer. If you have a desire to treat other subjects in detail, please query forthwith. In the instance of the sexual activity of those not dwelling within the veiling, each activity was a transfer. There were some transfers of strength. Most were rather attenuated in the strength of the transfer due to the lack of veiling. In the third density, entities are attempting to learn the ways of love. If it can be seen that all are one being, it becomes much more difficult for the undisciplined personality to choose one mate and, thereby, initiate itself into a program of service. It is much more likely that the sexual energy will be dissipated more randomly without either great joy or great sorrow depending from these experiences. Therefore, the green ray energy transfer, being almost without exception the case in sexual energy transfer prior to veiling, remains weakened and without significant crystallization. The sexual energy transfers and blockages after veiling have been discussed previously. It may be seen to be a more complex study, but one far more efficient in crystallizing those who seek the green ray energy center. Question 83.4. Questioner, let's take, then, since we are on the subject of sex, the relationship before and after the veil of disease, in this particular case venereal disease. Was this type of disease in existence prior to the veil? Answer, I am Ra. There has been that which is called disease, both of this type and others, before and after this great experiment. However, since the venereal disease is in large part a function of the thought forms of a distorted nature which are associated with sexual energy blockage, the venereal disease is almost entirely the product of mind-body-spirit complexes interaction after the veiling. Question 83.5. Questioner, you mentioned that it existed in a small way prior to the veil. What was the source of its development prior to the veiling process? Answer, I am Ra. The source was as random as the nature of disease distortions are, at heart, in general. Each portion of the body complex is in a state of growth at all times. The reversal of this is seen as disease and has the benign function of ending an incarnation at the appropriate space-time nexus. This was the nature of disease, including that which you call venereal. Question 83.6. Questioner, I'll make this statement and you can correct me. As I see the nature of the action of disease before the veil, it seems to me that the Logos had decided upon a program where an individual mind, body, spirit would continue to grow in mind and the body would be the third density analog of this mind. The growth would be continual unless there was an inability, for some reason, for the mind to continue along the growth patterns. If this growth decelerated or stopped, what we call disease would then act in a way so as to eventually terminate this physical experience so that a new physical experience would be started after a review of the entire process had taken place between incarnations. Would you clear up my thinking on that, please? Answer, I am Ra. Your thinking is sufficiently clear on this subject. Question 83.7. Questioner, the thing I don't understand is why, if there was no veil, the review of the incarnation after the incarnation would help the process, since it seems to me that the entity should already be aware of what was happening. Possibly this has to do with the nature of space-time and time-space. Could you clear that up, please? Answer, I am Ra. It is true that the nature of time-space is such that a lifetime may be seen whole as a book or record, the pages studied, riffled through, and reread. However, the value of review is that of the testing as opposed to the studying. At the testing, when the test is true, the distillations of all study are made clear. During the process of study, which you may call the incarnation, regardless of an entity's awareness of the process taking place, the material is diffused and over-attention is almost inevitably placed upon detail. The testing upon the cessation of the incarnative state is not that testing which involves the correct memorization of many details. This testing is, rather, the observing of self by self, often with aid as we have said. In this observation one sees the sum of all the detailed study, that being an attitude or complex of attitudes which bias the consciousness of the mind, body, spirit. Question 83.8. Questioner, now before the veil an entity would be aware that he was experiencing a disease. As an analogy would you give me, if you are aware of a case, a disease an entity might experience prior to the veil and how he would react to this and think about it and what effect it would have on him? Answer, I am Ra. Inasmuch as the universe is composed of an infinite array of entities, there is also an infinity of response to stimulus. If you will observe your peoples you will discover greatly variant responses to the same distortion towards disease. Consequently, we cannot answer your query with any hope of making any true statements since the overgeneralizations required are too capacious. Question 83.9. Questioner, was there any uniformity or like functions of societies or social organizations prior to the veil? Answer, I am Ra. The third density is, by its very fiber, a societal one. There are societies wherever there are entities conscious of the self and conscious of other selves and possessed with intelligence adequate to process information indicating the benefits of communal blending of energies. The structures of society before as after veiling were various. However, the societies before veiling did not depend in any case upon the intentional enslavement of some for the benefit of others, this not being seen to be a possibility when all are seen as one. There was, however, the requisite amount of disharmony to produce various experiments in what you may call governmental or societal structures. Question 83.10. Questioner, In our present illusion, we have undoubtedly lost sight of the techniques of enslavement that are used, since we are so far departed from the prevail experience. I am sure that many of service to others' orientation are using techniques of enslavement, even though they are not aware that these are techniques of enslavement, simply because they have been evolved over so long a period of time and we are so deep into the illusion. Is this not correct? Answer: I am Ra. This is incorrect. Question 83.11. Questioner: then you say that there are no cases where those who are of a service to others' orientation are using techniques of enslavement that have grown as a result of the evolution of our social structures. Is this what you mean? Answer: I am Ra. It was our understanding that your query concerned conditions before the veiling. There was no unconscious slavery, as you call this condition, at that period. At the present space-time, the conditions of well-meant and unintentional slavery are so numerous that it beggars our ability to enumerate them.